session we have seen about the SF6 circuit breaker. So in SF6 circuit breaker, though it has a dielectric strength twice to thrice that of the air, the main disadvantage was it has to be reconditioned after every operation. Now in today's session we will be seeing about the vacuum circuit breaker. So when you say it has a vacuum circuit breaker, here you are going to keep the vacuum at the range of 10 power minus 7 to 10 power minus 5 torr. So whenever the contact, that is your fixed and the moving contacts, they are going to be maintained at this vacuum level, it is going to exhibit a very high superior dielectric arc quenching property. So thus, when compared with your air or SF6, so it is going to have a superior arc extinguishing property, where you are going to extinguish the arc at current zero. And here, whenever you are going to do the arc extinction, as I already said, here the dielectric strength, it is going to be increasing 1000 times as when compared with your other circuit breakers. Now moving on to the construction, it is going to consist of a moving member and a fixed member, and here the unique feature is that extra you are going to have the bellows, okay, stainless steel bellows you are going to have. So for additional safety measure, you are going to have the inside arc shield and the outside further arc shield is there. So whenever you are going to consider this, you are going to have a moving contact and a fixed contact. You are going to have a arcing range. You are going to have, and you are going to have a arc shield. Okay, here whenever I am going to consider the moving contact, here it is going to have the bellows. Okay, so through this bellows, you are going to connect it to the control mechanism for its moving purpose. So now whenever the arc is going to get struck, it is going to result in the ionization of the metal vapors at the contacts, at the fixed and the moving contacts whenever a fault occurs. So this arc is going to struck because of the ionization of the metallic vapors at the tips. As a result, this metallic vapors, your electrons and ions are going to be produced. But since it is going to be maintained at a vacuum, so it is going to be quickly condensed by means this, by the metallic vapors, electrons and ions, they quickly condense on the surface of the fixed and the moving contacts. So the dielectric strength increases at a very higher, faster rate, and you can use it for interrupting the high fault currents. So here the unique measure is that you are going to have the arc shield, which prevents the any electrons or ions moving to the outer range. Further, you have the one more insulating vessel, which is going to be made up of the ceramic or glass. So it is entirely enclosed, moisture free, tight enclosing vessel is there, which prevents, that is your arc shield as well as your insulating vessel, it provides in preventing any electrons or any metallic vapors to get escaped. Thereby it provides a, it helps in maintaining the high dielectric strength. Okay, and here if you are going to usually see, you are going to use it for 22 to 66 kV, and you are going to use it for mainly for the outdoor application because it is maintenance free. The principle is going to be the same. Under a fault, the moving contacts are going to be moved apart and the arc is going to be struck because of the metallic vapors which is emerging from the tips of your fixed and the moving contact, and since it is going to be maintained at the vacuum, quickly it is going to be condensed on the surface of it, and thereby it is able to quench the arc. Now if you are going to see the power range, it is going to be used for 60 to 100 MVA. So where the, it is mainly used in places like India, the two in the rural areas, wherein the accessibility to the remote area is quite difficult. So you can install at the outdoor because it is maintenance free operation. So with this, I wind up today's session. In the next session, we will be seeing about the air brake circuit breaker. Thank you.